you have the information digitally. You can add, you can adjust. There is some sort of learning curve. It's much more precise and much better than it's the biggest step there is in.
Hi, and welcome back to Uniqa Dental Show. Today, we brought you a topic about CAD CAM. If you want to stay tuned and be part of the future, like, subscribe, and follow us. Hi, Dr. Yanil.
Hey, Vova.
How are you?
Great.
You like our plan?
Yeah, very much.
Yeah. We're connected.
Today, we're going to talk about CAD CAM. The evolution of the CAD CAM started when we were introduced to scanners, mm-hmm. not only intraoral scanners, but desktop scanners also. It started even previously when we had desktop scanners. Now we have intraoral scanners. It gives us a lot of options to approach from different perspective, and we have a lot of information for each case. When we scan, we have the exact information, we have the position of the information, and we can play with this information and make whatever we want, because previously, before the era of the CAD CAM, when we made a crown and we wanted to have a duplicate, we needed to make another crown, and it was never an exact duplicate of what we previously had. Now in the CAD CAM era, we have all the information we need, mm-hmm. and with this information, we can make duplicates, we can make adjustments, we can do everything we want, and it's all saved. We have all the versions, we can go from one to another. Today I brought different cases, and what we want to talk about today is different approaches with the CAD CAM era that we didn't have before. We couldn't do before the invention of the scanner and the milling machines.
Wait, and this, the new wave of 3D printers, it affects it also, right?
Yeah, of course, because if previously, mm-hmm. for example, 10, 15 years ago, you have a scanner and you had a machine, but you couldn't make a model. So now you can make everything digitally from the start, from the scanning. You can make the scanning with intraoral scanner. You don't need to have any impressions, traditional impressions at all. You have the information digitally in the computer. You can make a model. You don't need to do anything with this model because you can make the bridge already on the impressions you took before. So the model is just to see if it fits, if everything's fine, if you have any problems with aesthetics, if you want to add some ceramics. This is why you need the model. But your model is digital model.
And the patient don't need to come each time.
Yeah, and you save appointments using this information because you have everything on your computer. Today, we will show different cases and different approaches how to use the CAD CAM and different advantages. This is the first case I've wanted to show because in here you can see we have a tooth, not implant, nothing, and we want to make a crown. Mm-hmm. Now, to make perfectly symmetrical crown of tooth 11 with 21, it's very hard for manual manufacturing. In this case, what we did, we scanned, we mirrored the tooth, we made a crown. Now, it's not the first crown we made. We had different versions. In every version, we made some adjustments with the color, with everything. And in the end, even if she'll break this crown, we already have the information. We don't need to do anything. We just can take the exact copy of the crown, mill it again, color it again, and we have the same result. If you did it before with traditional methods, first of all, you can't do an exact copy. Mm-hmm. Every time you want to add something or remove something, you're losing the information of what was previously. So if something doesn't feel right, you don't know what was before. Every time, if you're making a PFM, for example, and you want to add ceramics, you need to go to the technician, give him the crown. You need to add ceramics, burn the crown, give back to the patient. In this case, you have the first crown. The patient, for example, says form of the crown needs to be a little bit corrected. So you have the first crown, you make a new crown. You can compare between the two crowns. in the same appointment. You can show her the first crown, you can show her the second crown, and in the end you'll get the exactly same crown with great color, everything you need, and you have a copy of the crown. If something happens to the crown, you just mill it again, make it again, and that's all. The second thing we've wanted to show is with all of the information you get, you can take, for example, an old denture and in the lab, in the same day, make new teeth. You can save the model of the teeth. You can add, you can adjust, you can do everything you want. And today with the printers, it's starting to be more and more popular. Because previously, mm-hmm. When you made dentures, you need to cure the denture, you need to position all the teeth right, you need to have models, you need to have all the information in the articulator. Now dentures starting to be much more easy process, because today you can print the denture, you can mill the teeth, you can just glue them one to another, and you have a final denture. In this case, the denture we did is metal based, so we took off the old teeth and replaced them with new ones. Everything was done in one day.
Some of the feedback that we received, we talked about the intraoral scanner. It was doctors that tried it and just gave up on it.
Look,
for this reason or another.
There is some sort of learning curve with the intraoral scanner. You need to understand, to feel the intraoral scanner. The same with traditional impressions. But when a doctor gets a new intraoral scanner, and for 20 years he took traditional impressions, it's something relatively new. He need to get used to the intraoral scanner, but from what I know, any doctor that got used to intraoral scanner never goes back. You can 99% of your impressions take with intraoral scanner. You have everything you need, and it's much more precise and much better than any traditional impression you can take.
Again, in those feedbacks that we received, in some of them, the doctors mentioned that the oral scanner has some sort of deviation.
On the one hand, you do have some sort of inaccuracies with the intraoral scanner. If you take one jaw with traditional methods, you'll have probably more accurate results. But all the occlusion, all the interocclusal relations, if you have some incorrectness in the impression, you don't know it until you have the end result, until you check the bridge and you see it doesn't fit. But with the intraoral scanner, you know from the beginning that you have problem, and you can fix the problem right away because you have everything on the screen. If you make a tooth preparation, for example, with the impression, you don't always know that the tooth wasn't prepared as best as it could. But with the intraoral scanner, you can see the angles of each tooth. You can see if you need to adjust something, to fix something, correct something before you send it for a crown manufacturing, mm-hmm. crown design. So you have much more information in the screen right next to your chair. The advancement of the scanner is very, very fast. 3 years ago, if you look at the program, at the scanners, at the technology itself, it changed a lot. Every year, the programs are updated and the changes. The scanners uses new technology. The computers are much faster. Everything changes very fast and you have much better result with very short amount of time. If you look at traditional impressions, the impressions today are exactly the same as they were 10 years ago and 20 years ago. The materials changed a bit, but there is no big breakthrough with the materials or with the technology.
So the next big thing will be the CAD CAM.
Yeah, you can't today do anything without a CAD CAM. It's the biggest step there is in dentistry.
So what are the steps in this case?
First of all, we took the denture and we scanned it. This denture was scanned with desktop scanner. When we scanned the denture, we know how the teeth are now, because you can see the teeth worn off a little bit. We took off the teeth, we left that just the metal carcass, and we scanned this also. We positioned them one onto another. So what you can see is you have a denture base, you have the old denture. Now on top of the denture base, you want to build new teeth. you want the teeth to be a little bit higher than the older teeth. You can design everything in the design programs. This one was designed with Exocad. You can see the new teeth, their design, the new height, because the older one were enough. You can see the occlusion, because when you took the impressions, in occlusion, you raised a little bit the occlusion to compensate on the new for the new teeth, and you can make the exact teeth that you need. If this case was made with plastic teeth that was placed manually, you couldn't receive the same occlusion as with CAD-CAM, because these teeth will be milled and later on will be cured on the denture base. So you will have exact occlusion. You don't need to change anything. The teeth are made for this case.
How long all this procedure took place?
In this case, everything was made in one day. We took the impressions, and by the end of the day, the patient got his denture back. The scanning, the modeling, the design was made in about 3-4 hours. Then the milling of the teeth is about 2 hours adding to that. And curing the teeth is also about 2-3 hours. So then what's left is polishing, some adjustments, and you have the teeth by 5. I think the patient got his teeth back.
Oh, nice. Yeah. By 5?
Around 5, yeah.
Yeah. If not using CAD-CAM, what would be the procedure?
If not using CAD-CAM, the procedure would be probably the same, but manually. But the problem is that if you're not using CAD-CAM, the process gonna take much more time. The end result won't be that accurate. And the technology is moving. You need today adjust yourself to the technology and not getting used to the old technology you have, because you have everything you need. You can make the perfect teeth for this case and not to choose from different kinds of teeth what more or less will suit you. So this is why CAD-CAM in this case, for example, is great, because you take the library teeth that you want. You know that all the teeth will be perfect for this case. You mill all the teeth together. Mm-hmm. You won't have breaking, you won't have chipping, you won't have anything with these teeth. Then you cure just the teeth to the plastic base, and you have a great result. Even these things you can right now do with CAD-CAM, using the CAD-CAM technologies, something you couldn't make before, and it would take you much more time and the end result won't be that good.
So today patients go through this procedure in a matter of hours?
Yeah, in a matter of hours. And today for the doctors, some doctors can do teeth in one day, restorations one day. Patients understand that with the new technology, you can get the work done much faster and have much better results. So some doctors don't understand how these cases can be made in one day, and they just use newer technologies, newer options, saves a lot of chair time. And in the end, chair time is what costs you money. You can receive more patients in the same time. What you see that we did here, we had the teeth milled with the new design of the teeth. The teeth perfectly matched the base of the denture. So you just place the teeth and you know they're in great positioning. You just need to add a little bit of wax for the curing that will be done later. And in the end, what you'll get is perfectly like new denture with the same metal base, with new teeth, all done in one day.
From the feedback that we got, we noted that patients started asking doctors if they could do the same procedure in this amount of time. It's becoming the new standard in denture. Faster procedures, on immediate loading.
Yeah, because first of all, patients see in advertisements, teeth in one day, they see that you can, a lot of treatments make in one day, and they don't want to give time to wait. I don't say that all the treatments should be made in one day, but with the new technology, many treatments can be made with one day. And to stay competitive, you need to adjust yourself to use the new technologies. You need to know how to make them in one day if you think it's the right thing to do. If you don't think it's the right thing to do, for example, implantations or something like this, you shouldn't do it in one day. If you have some benefits, to give it time. But if you can do it as faster as you want it, patients looking for it, and the patients are glad that you can make it as quick as possible and deliver the work right away.
You know what they say, why wait for tomorrow if you can do it today?
Exactly.
Thank you for being here today.
You're welcome.
Thank you also for tuning in. This was part one of a two-part show about CAD CAM. Stay tuned for more. Have a great week.